Hello, fellow rock and roll music and audio enthusiasts. Today I'm going to show my, I have to unbox it too. I'm going to show my, just came in the mail today, which is pretty sad providing I ordered it on November 13th. It is now December 20th. Took him over a month to actually ship it out. Then once he shipped it out, it got here in a couple days. So anyway, this is a Marantz Fit Model 5220. A single cassette deck front loading, in my opinion, the most beautiful cassette deck ever made. It is absolutely gorgeous. I've been wanting one for a while, but I've wanted one that was completely restored and, you know, I don't want any issues. And ironically enough, I also bought a Pioneer model CT-F700 off Facebook Marketplace on Saturday night. I'm going to pick that up today, so I'm getting both of my high-end cassette decks the same day. And this one's going to go upstairs on my main system, or my second main system with my Marantz receiver, obviously, my 4300, and the Pioneer's gonna go down here at my Sansui. That being said, it was $800 shipped when it's all said and done. And if anyone's wondering, that's my seller. Vintage Megalopolis. So yeah, you want to check his online store out. Actually, it looks like a nice Kenwood and a Kenwood receiver there too, and a looks like it with a Sansui underneath it. That looks like a Sansui. What's that? That looks like the 7001 QRX 7001. I'm not sure. There's another receiver under it too. It looks like. So yeah, this guy restores classic equipment. But yeah, I probably overpaid for it. I'm pretty sure I'm paying for that right there. But in any event, it's what I want. So one of these days I'll start collecting receivers too. But until I get rich, that ain't gonna happen. In fact, that probably ain't gonna happen for a long, long time. Anyway, unless my crypto coins take off. Man, I wouldn't do it where I wouldn't do it. I've known that Shiba Inu was going to be as big as it was this time last year. Or, oh man, $50 investment, I'd be a freaking billionaire. Alright, anyway, billionaire, not billionaire. $1,000 would have made me a billionaire. That's irrelevant. That's okay. As long as this came into me and got here undamaged, that's all I care about. I'll sit here and unbox this all night. Hope not for you guys' sake, though. I'm gonna use 1-inch. Please read. Okay. I'll block both of our addresses out. But I do highly appreciate the King Crimson icon up there in the court of the Crimson King. That's pretty cool. Well, it was actually $850 with tax and all that. Yeah, I probably overpaid for it. But you know what? At the end of the day, it'll last forever. So there we go. Here, I'll block his phone number out just out of respect. I'll give it a quick read then as soon as I'm done showing it to you. I'll skim through it. So yeah, he definitely knows his stuff, and he's I read the reviews on him. There's not one negative review on any of his listings. Yeah, I don't see any damage on the box at all. Let's say we're okay on that. I mean, it's a little crunch like right here, but on the back side, yeah, I'd say we're all right. Yeah,
Yeah, he even identifies it. All right, cool. Yeah, I'd say we're good at that. Yeah, he says here he usually doesn't ship outside of California, so he made an exception for me. I mean, for the price, I hope he did. Hope he would. Yeah, I think pretty good. Oh, cool! Even used biodegradable packing peanuts. All right, good stuff. Good stuff. Great. Obviously, I'm gonna get someone up. I'm not too worried about that. He's got a buffer in front of it. That's great. Looks like an inch thick, heavy piece of foam. Good, all right. Take this beauty out of the box. Oh, yeah. I'm gonna start cursing because it came in and I'll screw it up. Alright, you guys are seeing it before me. What's she look like?
Oh, yeah. I feel like I'm a little kid in the candy shop right now. Look at that. Wow.
Even more beautiful in person than it is
in the photos that I've seen. Alright. Well, I'm going to hook this up down in the basement for now because they're occupying the living room. So I was going to go in my man cave and we'll do a demo of it. And then you'll see it again when I do a video of my Marantz system upstairs. Well, not Marantz, it's a Marantz receiver that's the brains behind it, so I call it the Marantz system. Anyway, I'll see you as soon as I get these videos edited together. Hey guys, so we're about ready to do a demo on it. Let me set this back up for, okay. So I have a hook, I disconnected the CD player for now, I ran it in through the line out on that. I did not fire it up yet. Let's take a look at the back quick, as usual, before we start up. Unplug the line cord. Rotate it around. I hope that's set right. The line output level. I hope so. Looks like they're set even. I'm not even going to mess with it. FM calibration, I've been worried about that. FM deaverance, I'll just keep it flat. I'm not sure what it does, so I'm not going to mess with it. There's your data plate. I'm sure I bored you guys enough, so now it's time to hear it, listen to it, see it in action, so to speak. Not as heavy as it looks, but it still packs a little bit of weight. Okay, I did not fire it up yet. Oh, yeah. All right, so I have all these are pretty much already set in the middle, which that's where they're gonna stay. Right in the middle. Master level, keep that right in the center. Now let's see, take a look at some of the features we have. Limiter, so that's for recording, so if you have the recording level jacked up a little bit higher than you should, it won't record hot. As your bias selectors, I'm gonna keep it on all these cassettes I'm gonna be demoing with are normal bias. Dolby noise reduction on or off, I'm gonna keep that off. Dolby FM, just a selector switch. I think there's one called the model 5020 that doesn't have, I think it just doesn't have as many features on it. This is a big one. Memory on, I'm not sure what the hell that's gonna do. And here's your tape counter. Anyway, I love these mechanisms. I love them. I'm gonna start off with a Metal Church, The Dark. The song's called Start the Fire. Trust me, it rocks. I haven't used one of these yet, so bear with me. I think it just pops in like that, right? And then. Oh, how do you even load this up? Oh, what an idiot. There we go. Here goes nothing. Here what kind of sound quality we get out of it. Fast forward and rewind isn't really that fast, but oh, there it goes. As long as the playback and recording speed is right and dead on accurate, I could really give a shit less. But at the very least, the thing is absolutely gorgeous. It sounds nice too, and I have no EQ whatsoever. Everything's set to flat and loudness is off. Just so you're aware that we are not cheating at all in any way. I actually had to turn the loudness off because when I started the video, it was still on yet. All right. This is pretty cool. That shuts the door behind it and then just, that's neat. I love it.
The Who greatest hits. I picked this up at the Frackville, the Schuylkill Mall in Frackville, when that was still there years ago, when I was driving at POS 1994 Plymouth Acclaim. All I had was a cassette player, and I, you know, didn't have all my freaking cassettes ready to go yet. And I just remember, driving through wanting some tunes. I just looked at them like, I wonder if any of these this music store sells cassettes. And they did. It was a store called Blum's, which is still there down in Deer Lake. But they, before it was just an auction, they had a store section too where people could sell individual stuff. So it might not sound as good as Metal Church did, but we'll try it. Kid in the candy shop right now, not even joking. I love these MCA tapes with the blue writing too. It actually sounded very good for a pre-recorded tape. I mean, I expected the Metal Church one to sound good because those once the 80s rolled around, the pre-recorded cassettes were awesome. But a lot of times the earlier ones, like before Dolby noise reduction and all that, a lot of them leave a little bit to be desired as far as sound quality goes. But again, that wasn't terrible by any means. A classic. This is one of the ones I remember from a kid. My dad had this exact same one with that texture, with the Epic cassette with the textured border. Starts off slow and speeds up when you're in fast forward and rewind.
Oh,
Entirety after I'm done filming here. That is a freaking straight up rocker. 2 out of 3 ain't bad out of the side. That's probably the best song on the album. I got this one set for one of my favorites. Of course, I gotta do my favorite artist of all time. Can't get over this freaking loading mechanism. And also the fact that I felt like a complete brain dead retard when I first tried to freaking use it. I don't know why he shipped it with the loading mechanism down, but he did. Favorite quote of the whole entire song, favorite line, if you will. Anyway, guys, I'm really looking forward to seeing what people have to say about this. This deck is absolutely beautiful, in my opinion, the best looking and one of the best sounding cassette decks I've ever heard in my life, but definitely the best looking for sure. Like I said, and sound quality wise, it is no slouch either. Now, the test is going to be when I record a tape on it, which I actually am planning on doing a speed corrected transfer from the original vinyl press to cassette. And this is a deck I actually want to use to do that. So this should sound very good at that point in time. Anyway, guys, if you made it this far, thank you for watching, and please let me know what you think. I'm really looking forward to see what people have to say about this one. Yeah. Peace out, guys. Thank you for your support.